Finance Unit Section 1, Purchasing. We're going to do some comparison shopping so that we can get the most for the least amount of money, and to do that we'll do something called unit pricing. Here's an example of shopping for coffee. We have Maxwell House Original Roast Medium Ground Coffee. A 30.6 ounce container costs $20.49. The same product is also packaged in an 11.5 ounce container costing $3.64. We can approach this problem in different ways, but we need to be consistent so that the quantities need to be equalized so that a fair comparison can be made. If the quantities are different, how do you tell which option is better? We're going to do something known as unit price. Unit price involves us finding the cost per one, could be pound, foot, per 1 ounce, one fluid ounce, or some other quantity. The unit price is calculated by the formula taking total cost divided by the total quantity. And here's an example. We have some welding rods costing $13.68 and come in a package containing 37 rods. So to calculate the unit price, we'll replace total cost with the $13.68, total quantity with the 37 rods, and then do the indicated division, taking the numerator, 1368, divided by 37, the quantity, resulting in a price of 37 cents per rod. We could use this then to compare it to some other package having different number of rods in it and different price. When we're doing shopping, we need to also consider if there's additional costs. Had this been an item sold in a catalog or on the internet, there may be tax and shipping that add to the total cost. If we take that into consideration versus buying at the local store, now all of a sudden our unit price changes by adding that tax and shipping onto the cost of the rods for a total of $23.92 divided by 37 rods in the package, resulting in a unit price of 65 cents per rod, which is almost double the original 37 cents per rod. You're now ready to do practice set 1, page 3, problems 1 through 5.